Is Winston-Salem a good place for families? Yes. End of video. Just kidding. This video is not about different things to do and activities that you can do as a family, and it's not going to give just a bunch of different statistics about families and things like that. That would get kind of boring. Instead, Greater Winston-Salem Incorporated has one of its stated 2030 goals as being the best place to raise a family, so we're going to see how they're doing. Are they making good progress on that goal? What are they tracking? And then just how are they progressing on that goal in 2024? We're going to take a look at that today. So what it is, I asked over 15,000 local residents on Living in Winston-Salem whether Winston-Salem is family-friendly and why or why not. I wanted to see how the locals thought that we're doing in that regard. And boy, did we get some responses. Most of them good, not all of them, but most of them were good, but we did get some doozies in here. So we're going to move kind of rapid fire through some of these responses. That way you can decide for yourself if maybe Winston-Salem is a good place to raise a family or to bring your family if you're thinking about moving here. And if you need help buying or selling real estate, my contact information is on the screen and in the description below. So I'm going to read these responses directly as they came in, but and then we'll just discuss them really briefly. One of the things I really like about Winston-Salem, including Greater Winston-Salem Incorporated, is they understand that there's work to be done. It's not, you know, stagnant, just kind of sitting back and relaxing. They're definitely want to try to improve. That's different from other places that I lived, and I really do appreciate that about them. But Greater Winston-Salem is also tracking this in a few different metrics that I'll just mention really briefly. And I do want to point out they're trending up in all of these areas that they're measuring. So first is overall population, and we've talked about that before, how Winston-Salem is growing. And when I say Winston-Salem in this video, actually I just mean Forsyth County in general. So that includes the surrounding suburbs. But population is growing steadily, you know, 1-2. We had a brief point where they grew at 3% 1 year, but it's really just that steady growth. And then we look at new job creation. They're trending up there as well, where Winston-Salem generally has an unemployment rate that is a little bit lower than the national average. Then we have high school graduation rate that is trending up at over 87%. And last, where Winston-Salem has made some really good strides is in the median household income, which is up over $58,000 per year. And just a few years ago, that was in the 30s and 40s. So it's nice to see some progress in the median household income. Like I said, all that's great, but I wanted to hear what do the locals, the people that have lived here for, you know, whether it's 5 years like me or 1 year or their whole life, I'm interested to hear what the locals said. So let's get right into it. So the question was, is Winston-Salem a good place for families? Why or why not? It is a good place for families, but we need more daycare options. And I've heard this a few different times. We've talked about it briefly before, but daycare in Winston-Salem can be a little bit tricky. If you're thinking about moving here, you need to get on those lists early and start doing your research a little bit ahead of time, especially because when school is about to start, they can really, really fill up quick. On a side note, if anybody feels entrepreneurial and they wanted to open up a daycare, I bet it would do really well here. So next one. Yes, I love the close-knit feel of my neighborhood, and they called out Sherwood Forest. And Winston-Salem has some really distinct close-knit neighborhoods, and they're really kind of known for their sense of community. But it is important to know that this can vary neighborhood by neighborhood, right? Some are going to be more so than the others. Sherwood Forest, Buena Vista, Ardmore, those are the ones that a lot of people talk about for being really close-knit. My little neighborhood, I live in a small neighborhood in Louisville, and it's not going to make any of the lists. It's probably not something that you had heard of before, but I would say it is very close-knit feeling. There are people out on walks all the time in the neighborhood. People are, you know, courteous. They wave to each other or stop and chat for just a minute with the neighbors. So very family friendly and just friendly overall. But some things to know is that, but like I said, that can vary neighborhood by neighborhood. You know, some just aren't known for that. If a neighborhood is, say, aging out and kind of turning over, right, where older people are moving out and younger people are moving in, that might have a little bit different feel than some of these other neighborhoods that we talked about. So if that's something that's important to you, we just want to make sure that we really watch out for that. So the next one is about schools, and I'm going to just kind of do a two for one here because they're both discussing schools. There are some really good schools here, much better than where we moved from. And then the other one was, I learned really quickly that the quality of the schools can vary widely in Winston-Salem. And that is something worth mentioning. You know, when I'm talking to people considering moving here, one of the first things that I always want to ask about is schools. Luckily, there are some really good resources for that here. And in Winston-Salem, you're going to find some of the highest ranked schools in the state, and you're going to find some that aren't ranked as high and some that aren't ranked really well at all. They can vary widely in Forsyth County. Now, just a couple points about that is there are some really good resources, you know, gradeschools.org or niche.com will have some school ratings that you can always take a look at. I will mention, though, there were some schools that I've had clients go to where they, you know, the schools weren't ranked as high on maybe some of these websites, but they absolutely love the school that their student is in. So if you have questions or concerns about that, don't be afraid to dig a little bit deeper. You know, schools and real estate, a little bit of a touchy subject. I will guide you however I can if we're working together on that. But I agree, the school, the rankings can vary widely within Forsyth County. All right, next one. Honestly, Winston-Salem is the most family-friendly city I've lived in, and I heard some variation on this quite a few times, which is really refreshing to hear. This person went on to name a bunch of the different things to do that I'm not going to list, but you know, between museums and parks and all those good things like that, lots and lots of stuff to do in Winston-Salem for families. So again, next one is Winston-Salem family-friendly. Not if your kids have bad allergies or want to play in the snow. Both of those are probably true. You've probably heard about allergies in Winston-Salem. The spring pollen season can get pretty bad here. I've learned that I alternate. I don't remember the two names of them, but I'll alternate between the two different main types of allergy medicine throughout the spring and into the summer. I love in the fall and winter when that stuff kind of goes away and you get kind of back to normal. But yeah, allergy season is bad and playing in the snow. Yes, not good here. Well, Winston-Salem, if you average it out over a long time, it gets several inches of snow per year. The last couple of years, we have not really gotten any snow. And when we do get it, it just really usually sticks around just for that, you know, a few hours, maybe that day, and it's a very, very small amount. But if you want to go tubing or something like that, I mean, Virginia, in just a couple hours away, you can go and you can go play in some snow. So I guess if you really miss it, I don't. But if you really miss it and the kids want to go play in the snow, there are a few options for you, but not typically here. Okay, next one. Yes, it is so easy to get around for more variety. I can be at North Carolina Zoo in an easy 45-minute drive. The Greensboro Science Center and water parks are only 30 minutes away, and there are plenty of trails and parks right in town. This is a good one. It highlights just some of the ease to commute around the city and surrounding areas. Side note, did you know North Carolina Zoo is the largest natural habitat zoo in the world? I've never been there. Both of my kids went there on field trips. They said it's pretty cool and it is just massive. There's also a really cool zipline park out that way too. But anyway, I don't want to get too sidetracked on that. But the moral of that story is it's just really easy to get around to all the different amenities. And even if it's just outside of Winston-Salem, really simple. All right, next one is Winston-Salem family friendly. Yes, but there are areas to stay away from. I'm also noticing more and more upcoming neighborhoods and new businesses every year. This is a good one too. You know, typical for a city, right? There are going to be some areas that are better than other areas of the city. I don't think that comes as any surprise. Winston-Salem is no different in that regard. But talking about new businesses and up-and-coming neighborhoods every year, that's something I've noticed in the 5 years that I've been here as well. I've been able to see some neighborhoods that have really, you know, changed for the better. And there are some areas like around Cobblestone Farmers Market. Not only is that neighborhood getting better and changing there, you know, housing is getting improved with more different options. More newer and rehabbed homes are coming in there. There are condos and townhomes coming down there. But there are also some of Winston-Salem's most exciting new small businesses there too, from, you know, shopping to eating, breweries, all those different things. So it's really cool to see a city where, you know, these small little neighborhoods that Winston-Salem has doesn't have the huge giant neighborhoods that you might be familiar with. They're smaller neighborhoods, but it's really cool to see that these are just kind of changing for the better, giving people more options to live, eat, work, play. All right, next one. Winston-Salem is very family-friendly and no long commutes anywhere, and it's easy to get in and out of sporting events like the Dash or Wake Forest. I thought this was a good one that didn't come to my mind right away. If you didn't know, I'm pretty anti-traffic. It's one of the things I appreciate most about Winston-Salem, and I've definitely become spoiled in Winston-Salem. But getting in and out of like a Dash game or a game at Wake Forest is really, really simple. If you've ever been to a major sporting event in another city, you know, that gridlock that can just be kind of annoying or difficult, or you have to, you know, park blocks and blocks and blocks away. This is, you know, on a smaller scale. So, but one of the benefits of that is there are a lot more family-friendly activities at these things typically. And if you're shuttling around the kids or they're losing their patience and they're just ready to go to bed at the end of the game, it's nice that it's easy and you're not gonna just sit in traffic for an hour trying to get out of the ballpark. Next one is Winston-Salem good for families. Yes, because there are a ton of family-friendly restaurants and breweries. Good story illustrating this point perfectly. It was about 2 or 3 weeks ago. I went to go check out a new barbecue food truck that was at a brewery in Winston-Salem, right on the edge of Winston-Salem in Louisville. I went out there, we got there, you know, right around dinner time, 6 o'clock or something like that. And it was packed with families. I mean, it was just, the parking lot was full. People were hanging out, having a brewski, but just a lot of families there, a lot of, you know, and I mean younger kids, you know, 5, 6, 7, you know, people just kind of hanging out, having a good time. The food truck was busy. It just looked like a really neat scene at this place where they just kind of got that mix between brewery, family friendly with what looked like a really good food option. I did not get to try the barbecue that day, but I will. Outside of that, a lot of the breweries here are family friendly and a lot of the restaurants are really family friendly as well. One thing that comes to mind pretty quickly is the Coal Pit right in downtown in Bailey Park. You have, you know, Incendiary Brewing right there, Cugino Forno Pizza, and a couple other places that are right there. The Coal Pit is a good place to go kind of hang out. The kids can run around and play down there. Always a really good family spot right downtown. All right, next one is Winston-Salem family friendly. Yes, as long as you have a car, it is. Point taken. There are not a lot of walkable areas right in Winston-Salem outside of downtown and a couple different neighborhoods, but for the most part, you're going to need a car because public transportation here is just not the best. There's not a lot of variety of it. I have heard from people that the Uber and Lyft situation is better kind of post-pandemic if you wanted to get around without a car. But again, having a car is probably a necessity in most of Winston-Salem. Okay, next one. Emphatic yes. Since moving here, I'm able to work very part-time and spend time with the kids because it is less expensive to live here. That's one of the probably the biggest draws to Winston-Salem at first is the overall affordability. Our housing here tends to be much less than the national average. So we do see a lot of families, you know, selling a house in a more expensive location, moving here, taking some of that equity, and really enjoying a lower payment that can really help change their quality of life. Maybe like for this person, it was being able to only work part-time instead of two people having full-time jobs, so you can spend more time with the kids or volunteer or whatever it is that you want to do. But affordability is obviously a big draw and can make that more family friendly. I was really grateful at the amount of participation we got in this and some of the responses we got. We got tons and tons of them. Maybe I'll make another video going over more of these, but you know, the overall consensus is, you know, no city's perfect. There are gonna be pluses and minuses to everything. I do try to be balanced in some of these, but overwhelmingly, people really seem to think Winston-Salem is a family-friendly city. What do you think? Tell me in the comments below. And if you're thinking about buying or selling real estate anywhere in Winston-Salem or the surrounding area, I'd love to be a resource for you. You can reach out to me directly at jeff@govalentino.com. Thanks.